bag was on a leash like that. Yonks. Okay, so let's hope I didn't get a copyright strike for that. Okay, so hello everyone, welcome to a video of me hauling books for the month of May. Yes, my May book haul. Okay, so I have 14 books to show you guys today that I am very, very, very excited about. Yes, you heard that right, 14, and a bitch got no shame because I don't, and I don't, and I don't apologize, and I don't give a fuck. So, yes, we're gonna get to these. So, I'm gonna start with the ones that were sent to me first. The first one is Goosebumps Wanted, The Haunted Mask. This is by Arl Stein, of course. This was sent to me by Cody over at Pimp Book Review. He wanted to send it to me as a little gift, and I got it, and it's amazing. And thank you again, Cody, for sending it to me. You were super awesome. And the really cool thing about it is that it's green, which is gorgeous. And the dust jacket, when you turn it around, it's like a big poster, which, that is awesome. That is awesome. I probably will not put it up because, you know, I like my books with my dust jackets, but it's gorgeous. So thank you again, Cody. That is just amazing. And if you haven't read the Goosebumps series, get on that. Okay? Okay. The next one is The Inquisition by Taran Matharu. Did I say that right? I'm sorry if I didn't. This is the second book in the Summoner series. I have not read the first one, but I was sent this by Macmillan. Also, the author contacted me to see if I wanted to read the series. I said yes. So I am excited to get to it. I'm in my middle grade mood, so I don't know when I'm going to get to this series, but it's here if I, you know, love the first book. Second one's right here. But the cover of the first one looks really cool, and this is green and gorgeous, and it matches my eyes. Yawn. Okay, so next three I am super, super excited about. So you guys know in my top books that I want to read in 2016 video, I told you guys that, the second part of that, I told you guys that I really wanted to read The Evil Wizard Smallbone, and I told you guys that I contacted Candlewick Press, and they were really awesome with me. Well, they sent it to me. They sent me an amazing arc of it. This is The Evil Wizard Smallbone by Delia Sherman. And look at this, okay? I want you guys just to fucking just take a good gander at this motherfucker. Just, it's middle grade, and almost all of these are middle grade. But look how beautiful this is. Just, whoa, just amazingness. Just, and if you want a better look at it, you can go on Goodreads, but it's just, it's beautiful, and I cannot wait for the actual hardcover to come out. But this comes out in September 2016. I just forgot the actual release date, which is really stupid of me, but I'm very, very excited about this. This is about a young boy named Nick who is 12 years old, right? Yeah. He runs away from home in a blizzard, and he ends up at a bookstore that is run by a grumpy wizard. And the wizard is like telling him, you know, I'm the boss ass bitch. Like, no one fucks with me. I am the baddest mofo in the world. And, you know, which the boy finds out is not really, you know, the truth when another wizard is sort of challenging him. And there are these shape-shifting wolf bikers, which sounds really fucking awesome. And I'm just really, really excited to read this. I know this comes out September. I'm just, like, I know I have to get the video up by September, but I'm just so excited to read this. Like, I think I'm going to read this really, really early, even though it takes place, you know, in the wintertime. But sounds awesome. And also, they sent me two more arcs, you guys. Two more arcs. So I'm just really, really excited about these. The next one is also middle grade, and that is Still a Work in Progress by Joan Knowles. And this one is a contemporary. And this one actually sounds really, I'm not really one for contemporary, well, I am. I don't know what I'm saying. But I gotta be in the right mood for it. But this one sounds really good. This is about these two boys who are sort of just dealing, you know, with, I think it's middle school. Yeah, I think it's like middle school life. And the main character's sister suffers from an eating disorder. And when that comes to light, just a bunch of crap starts happening. So this sounds really good. And I'm really, really excited to get to it. And there's this really cute cat on the cover. It's really cute. But this one comes out in August 2016. So, you know, get on that if you like books like that. Then the next one, which is the last one that they sent me, I told you guys that I was not really interested. I'm going to turn my chair because I feel like I'm just turning this way the whole time. That I'm not really interested in sci-fi books, and I really am not. But I saw this and I was like, oh, it's sci-fi, maybe I don't know if I like it. Okay, this changed my mind completely. So it's called Phoenix, and it's by S.F. Saeed, and it's illustrated by Dave McKean. If you don't know who Dave McKean is, but he does all the covers for, like, not all the covers, but he does most of the covers for Neil Gaiman's books, and he's a really amazing illustrator. And this one is a sci-fi book, it's middle grade, and it's about this boy whose name is Lucky, and he lives on this planet, sort of like, does he live by himself? No. Yeah, okay, and this whole war happens with all of these aliens, and horned cloven-hooved aliens, and he has, like, this power that he needs to, you know, sort of wield to get rid of these crazy aliens. And it says, a boy with unprecedented power, I'm sorry, I can't talk today, must turn to the terrifying alien enemies of humanity to discover his true nature and bring peace to a galaxy at war. So when I read that, I was like, oh, it sounds really interesting. And then it says, for fans of Star Wars, which I haven't really seen Star Wars, so, you know, you can freak out about that below. But the reason why I was like, you know what, I'm gonna give this a go, let me show you guys, okay? Okay, look at this. Illustrations. This is full of illustrations. It's like, it reminds me of Brian Selznick's books, where they're just, like, it's all, like, half of them are illustrations and half of them is, like, story. And that's what this is like, but it's, like, half and half back and forth. So there are awesome illustrations. There's the next page right there. And then there's the next page right here. And then there's some that's just, like, regular, you know, pages. But it's mostly all illustrations, which this is just so freaking beautiful, you guys. This is beautiful. So I am actually very, very excited to get to this. This one comes out in October, but just because of the illustrations, I'm really, really excited about it. So I'm hoping that I'm gonna like this one, but very, very excited about those. And then the rest of these I got from Amazon.com, and then the last ones I got from the library book sale. So the first one that I got off Amazon is Curiosity House Book 2, which is called The Screaming Statue by Lauren Oliver and H.D. Chester. And this one I am currently reading right now. I'm being very, very slow with it, which I think is because everything's just been really busy right now. By the time this goes up, I might be done with it, but I don't know. I'm not sure. But this one so far is really, really good. I'm about 137 pages in, and I really, really love it, and it's beautiful. It's just as beautiful as the first one. Really, really pretty, matching spines. It's just, oh my gosh, and the first book was really good. And on the inside, the end paper is really cool, like Victorian-esque design. And then when you take the dust jacket off, let me do this for you guys, because I know you guys are gonna be like, oh my goodness, about this. Look at this. Just like the first one, it's got a beautiful, beautiful naked ass. Yes, look at this. Look at that. Beautiful. Look at the silhouettes, and it's, oh, I love purple, and it's got a little bit pink hues too. So that is gorgeous. Yes. Then the next one, and I think I'm really gonna love that one. Yes, so the next one is The Spindlers. This is by Lauren Oliver as well. So now I pretty much own all of Lauren Oliver's middle grade books, and I am very, very excited about that. This one is about a young girl whose brother gets switched, and the boy who's, like, he's replaced with is not her real brother, and she's trying to figure out what happened to him, and then she ventures off into this underground world where she's trying to retrieve him. So this one just sounds really fun and whimsical, and I'm very, very excited about it. And the cover is absolutely stunning, just all the way around. There's nothing really interesting, you know, it's just embossed and all that, but, you know, I really wish all of her middle grade books had really awesome things in them. But yeah, this is just amazing, and I cannot wait to get to this one. Then the next one is one that I'm pretty sure that you guys are going to see a lot on BookTube really, really soon. And that is Some Kind of Happiness by Claire Legrand. This is gaining so much momentum right now, and I'm so, so happy for her. Because if you guys don't know, I love Claire Legrand. I loved I just forgot what it was called. The Cavendish Home for Boys and Girls. And I loved it so much that I've just decided that I want to read all her middle grade stuff. And this one just came out. And look at the beautiful cover. I'm saying and a lot. It's really pretty. You can see all these little gold flecks. It's gorgeous. All the way around, it's green. It's beautiful. On the inside, it's regular and green. It's really pretty and gold. But this one is a middle grade book. But this one has a lot to do with mental illness. And I am very, very, very excited to read something like this. And on here it says, I'm going to read you guys a summary so that I don't fuck this up for you guys. But let me read it. Where is it? Finley Hart is sent to her grandparents' house for the summer, but her anxiety and overwhelmingly sad days continue until she escapes into her writings, which soon turn mysteriously real, and she realizes that she must save this magical world in order to save herself. So, yeah. I mean, as you can tell from that, this sounds like it's gonna fuck me up, and I'm down for it. Very, very, very excited about this one. My camera is just like, it's only letting me record 12 minutes, so... Yeah, I didn't want to edit this video, but oh well. But again, very, very excited about it. I don't know what I'm saying. Okay, so the next one is The League of Beastly Dreadfuls by Holly Grant. Look at it's like hilarious. This cover is absolutely hilarious. I love it so much. This one is. I want to read there's a warning on the back, which I think is freaking awesome. It says, warning, this book is chock full of dreadful things, calamity, evil plans, attacking poodles, and is not suitable for nice little boys and girls. Take my advice, practice your posture instead. Yeah, so that just sounds fun, and look at this, the end paper is gorgeous, and this is about this little girl whose parents died, if I'm not mistaken, and you know what, fuck it, let me just read this summary. Anastasia, nearly 11, is snatched from her elementary school and sent to live at a former insane asylum with two great aunts she has never met after being told that her parents died in a tragic vacuum cleaner accident. I mean, who wouldn't want to read it after that? And then the first sentence is going to hook you, okay? Just listen to this. Anastasia's day began with a funeral, and it went downhill from there. I mean, who wouldn't want to read this after that? So, it sounds awesome. This is the first book in a series, but it sounds hilarious, and I'm fucking excited for it. The next one is The Society of 13 by Gareth P. Jones. And this one, I got off Amazon Marketplace. This is the UK edition because it's not available in the US at all. Like, they haven't even published it here, which is, I just hate that about US publishers, you know, because there are really, really awesome books that are only available in the UK, and if only US publishers would just pick them up, you know, with all this other crap that they pick up. But yeah, okay, that little rant over. But this one, I'm going to read the back to you guys because look at this. It's gorgeous. And this also was giving me a little bit of Lee Sloan Poe feel, so that's why I got it. And this says, London, 1891. 13-year-old orphans Tom and Esther are in the most peculiar situation. Recruited by the enigmatic Lord Ringmore to run errands for his Society of 13, a clandestine group of gathering to uncover mysteries of the occult. They find themselves drawn into an extraordinary world of conjurers, magic, and peril. And with the appearance of a mysterious spellbook, a talking magpie, and a perplexing green-eyed cat, things are about to get even stranger. So, this just sounds like... This just sounds like a fucking good-ass time, and I'm very, very excited about this one. And the cover, again, it's gorgeous. I'm in love with it. Then the next ones I got from the library book sale. This was a library edition. Like, it had, like, the stickers and crap all over it, but I cleaned it up, and it looks cute now. Still has, you know, the stamp up here, which says El Paso Public Library. But this one, I've been wanting to read this one for so long. Like, I saw it in my library years ago, and I was just like, it sounds interesting, but I don't know. And then I went back to my library looking for it again. I didn't remember what it was called. I just remembered the spine. And then I could never find it. And then I went to the library book sale recently, about a couple, maybe like a few days ago. And I saw it, and I was like, holy shit. So then I grabbed it. It was only a quarter. It's a hardback. It's kind of beat up, but just a little bit, but it's okay. And the cover of it is absolutely beautiful. There's this cat in a cage. There's a person flying over here, which sounds awesome. This takes place in a future, right? Says, in a future New York where most people can fly and cats are a rarity, a nondescript resident of Hope House for the homeless and hopeless discovers that although she is shunned as a lead foot, she has the surprising ability to become invisible. So, yeah, so this just sounds really fun. I read like the first couple of pages of it and I was like, yeah, this is gonna be fun. And on the back it says, an invisible girl, an impossible boy, an incredible city, an extraordinary adventure. So, yeah, I'm very, very, very excited about that one. And then the last three are all adult, right? They're all adult books. And I got them because I'm not in, like, the mood to read these at all right now. But I was like, you know what? I'm going to be in the mood to read these sometime. And I want them on my fucking shelf because they were fucking cheap. So I bought them. And they are Chevy Stevens' That Night. And look at this cover, you guys. It's beautiful. It has a freaking leaf. A fall leaf right here. It's beautiful. This one is about a woman who, when she was young, she was accused of killing her younger sister along with her boyfriend. She was sent to prison and she gets out and she's just trying to figure out who actually killed her sister because she didn't. So this just sounds really awesome and it will be on my shelf ready for me when I fucking want to read it. Then the next one is, these last two I've been seeing a lot on BookTube. Of Things Gone Astray by Janina Matheson. This is like is it full of short stories, right? Yeah. But it was $2 and it was 50% off, so I only paid $1 for it. And the cover of it is really, really pretty. Look at that. There's a lot of mixed reviews about it, but you know, I'll decide whether I'm gonna like it or not. Then the last one is one that I am actually really, really excited to read. So when I'm in the mood for it, I'm gonna be, yeah, I'm excited about it. It is really, really pretty. I like it a lot. In a Dark, Dark Wood by Ruth Ware. That is a very, very interesting cover. I'm thinking those are tree branches. Yeah, it's just, I thought they were scratch marks. I think they're tree branches. This was $3, but 50% off. And it says that, like, if you like Gillian Flynn, then you'll like this. And then I've been seeing reviews of it on BookTube, so and again, it has mixed reviews, but it just sounds really, really good. And it's short, it's only like 200 and something pages, and I am really, really excited about this one. So yeah, I'm excited to have this one on my shelf along with the rest of these beautiful motherfuckers. And yeah, so I will see you guys next time with another video. Like, let me know if you guys have read any of these, what you think of them. You know, but don't give me any spoilers, as you guys know I always say. Yeah, and if you have any books that you want to recommend to me, you can recommend them below. Mostly middle grade, because I'm not reading anything else but middle grade right now. And yes, also, if you haven't, go subscribe to the Mystery Corner channel, because we will be starting June 6th on there. And I'll put the link to that below. And yeah, so this drink is watered down now. But yeah, alright, so I will see you guys next time. Bye!